Good day, everyone. In today's lecture, we will be discussing part 2 of chapter 1 or section 1, which is entitled The Python Basics. So as you can see here, in section 1 or chapter 1, in our previous discussion, we review some of the basic concepts in calculus. And in this lecture, we will be discussing Python basics. I know that some of you already know how to run a Python program. Okay, as you recall, in our Google classroom, as you can see here, in your classwork, in lesson 1, you learn in this lesson how to install the IDE Spider, and you also discuss in lesson 2 about functions, lesson 3 about if statements, and conditional statements, basic loops, how to input and output file, and we have also here about class inheritance. And lastly, the math library in Python. Okay, so it may be there's a difference in my end because I use a Linux operating system. So maybe in your case you are using Windows operating system. So anyway, there's not much difference in how to run a code in Python. So there are several ways on how to run a Python code. In your case, if you are using Windows operating system, you can type it in your Google browser, this URL. Or, for example, in my case, I'm going to copy this one, and then I'm going to paste it here, and then click enter, and then you will see this. This one. Okay, so since I'm using a Linux operating system, it's like a magic here that it already detected my operating system. So I'm going to click the download button here, and then it will automatically download the software. Okay, so that's the first, and then after that, after installing, you can see the Spider environment. So in my case, for example, in my case, I will click this one first, and then I am going to type, for example, this one here. I use my terminal to open the Anaconda. Okay. After this, I'm going to type the another code to open my Anaconda. This one, navigator. And then, so this happens because I am using the Linux operating system. So maybe in Windows, you can see in the desktop or at the bottom here, you can type the Anaconda and then click it, and then it will open for you. Okay, so let's wait for a while. system is loading the unauthenticator. Okay, wait, let's just wait. Okay, so there's, you can see here the icon. So this is my unauthenticator, and in this one at the bottom you can see here the spider ID. Okay, so I can click launch, and then after some moments it will load up my spider ID. So this is what it looks like using spider. Okay, so anyway, I minimize that one. So another way on how to run a code is using editors or environments like Jupyter, PyCharm, or the built-in Python shell. So you can visit this website. So again, you can right-click and then you can type it in the Google browser. Then you will be able to download the appropriate version of Python. So either you can either use the Python 2 or Python 3. So it depends on you. Let's say in my case, let's open my Python shell. So let me type it in the terminal. Maybe here, somewhere here, let's say this one, ID. Okay, so this is my Python shell, and the version is 3.9.7. Okay, so you can run the code here. For example, you can use Python as a calculator, so press 3. Suppose you have 5 here, so enter. So as you can see here, there's an error. It says here that the name sign is not defined. So what we need to do here is to call the package first. So let's say let's import. I know you already know this method, import math. And then something like import from math import let's say sign pi and log. Okay, and then let's try again, sine 0.5. Okay, so the answer is 0.4794. Okay, so that's how you are going to run a code using the Python shell. Or if you will use the Anaconda Navigator, you can launch let's use a spider first. Where is the spider, where are you? This one. Maybe you can type it here, like again, let's try sine 0.5 so there's an error. So just like before, first is you have to import the package. Import from math. Import sine log, and let's say pi. Okay, and then we have sine of pi over 2, let's say the answer is 1. Okay, so if you are using the spider IDE, then you can use this area here as to evaluate the code. Okay, so let's try to close that one, and then you can also use the Jupyter notebook. Let's launch the Jupyter notebook, for example, and then click the new button here, and then click Python 3. Okay, after that, just like in Spider, you can use the Jupyter notebook as a calculator. Let's say Shift Enter. Okay, so you are going to use Shift Enter to evaluate the code. Let's say again sine of 0.5. Sorry, Shift Enter. So as again, there's we have to load first the package. Okay, so just do the same as we have done before. Okay, so let's close this one first. Okay, let's quit this one, and then let's quit also this one. Let's open this new terminal, and then let's try this one again. Okay, so either you can use the you can use Jupyter notebook or Spider or PyCharm to run a Python code. So I put a comment here somewhere. This is from your Google Classroom. We discussed in already the basic math computations. We have NumPy arrays, plotting, matrix operations, and so on and so forth. Okay, so but anyway, what happened if there's still an error in evaluating a program, so or a code? So maybe in your end, in your case, maybe the package is missing. Okay, if the package is missing, then you have to install it. So for example, let's try, let's open a let's open our browser here. For example, if you have this one, so these are the most important or popular Python packages in 2021. So you can scroll down here, we have NumPy. There are in numerical analysis, most of the packages that we are going to use is the NumPy package, the SciPy package, this one here, and also the Matplotlib or Matplotlib package. Where's that one here? Maybe it's somewhere here. Pandas also is important package. We have Matplotlib is very important for graphics, okay, for visualization. So let's try this package here. We have NumPy. It says here that NumPy is used for advanced array operations, can add, multiply, slice, reshape, or index, comprehensive mathematical functions. We have random number generation, linear algebra routines, and Fourier transforms. So if you are using the, if you are making a code or program that involves a Fourier transform or linear algebra matrices, how to multiply matrices, or you can do random number generation or comprehensive mathematical function, then you need this package, NumPy package. So for pandas, CC, if you are going to use reading writing data from CSV and Excel files and SQL databases, then you need pandas for package. Reshaping and pivoting data sets, slicing, mixing, and subsetting data sets, aggregating and transforming data, merging and joining data sets, you will use pandas. For Matplotlib, let's see, if you want to draw a graph, let's say y is equal to 2x, z is equal to x squared, then you need this package. Okay, so for me, I use PIP install to install an individual package. Maybe you can search for this one, installing using PIP. This one here, in your case, if you are using a Windows operating system, then it may be different from that show my face somewhere here. Okay, this one. Okay, and then open the browser and also the identity. Okay, that one. Okay, so we have to import NumPy as NP. Click enter. And then type next space box. And then space NP. That range from, let's try to say, 0 to 100. Okay, correct. After this, by 1 is equal to x times 2, and then z is equal to x exponent. Finally, this one, let's try to copy it. Copy and paste it here. After that, let's try to copy this one also. I hope this will work. And then let's try to copy this one. Copy. Paste it here. Enter. Okay, there's an error. So maybe syntax multiple statements found while compiling a single statement. So maybe we have to copy paste it one by one. Okay. Copy. Let's try this method. After that, copy this one again. It's very tedious. Okay, paste, enter. What happened? So there's an error. Maybe we can try spider to run the code. Enter. Okay, and then this one here. This one. Finally. Okay, how about this one? There's really a problem here. Let's try to paste it. And then this one. Copy. Still it not works, so the output must be like this. Maybe let's try opening another. Let's exit this one and then let's exit my face here. I'm sorry, this one. And then let's try to open the Anaconda Navigator. And then this one here. Okay, so we have to wait. And then let's try to run this code here using matplotlib. What I wanted to show you is if you did not install the matplotlib package, then there will be an error. So let's try to run this one in the spider. Maybe it will run this time. Okay, so let's launch the spider. Okay, and then copy this one. So let's copy this one here. Then let's erase all these things. Okay, let's erase that one. and then space this. Okay, enter. And then also, let's try to copy this code. Copy, paste. Okay, and then click this button here, run. So this is the graph. So it shows us that the graph in the Brave browser is correct. This is the output, which is the same as this one here. Where are you? This one. Okay. So either way, either if you use the Python shell or the Spider IDE, then maybe it will work in the other one, but it will not work in the other. Okay, so that's how you are going to run a code in Python. And also, before I end, I'll give you some hint. If you want to study more about the math module or the NumPy module or SciPy module, then you can type it in your Google browser about that module, everything you need to know about that module, and then try to run it in the Spider or in the Jupyter notebook or in the Python shell. It depends on how you are comfortable with the IDE. So don't forget to import first the package, and then try something like this one, MathPy. So there's a difference between, for example, here, if I type pi here, shift enter, so the pi, the name pi is not defined. So since you did not call the package first, let's say import math, and then let's say math dot pi. Oh, sorry. So this is how you are going to evaluate. It's 3.1416. So try some values here. Maybe you can let's say this one here. Factorial, this one here. Let's try factorial. Okay, let's try factorial here. No, that one, not that one. Where are this one? Let's say okay, there's a math here. Let's say we have factorial. Factorial, let's say 3. The answer is 6, but however, there is an error, so meaning to say you did not call the math package first. So you should include here factorial, but the other way is to write math the factorial and then type 3. So the answer is 6. So be careful. Be careful in typing a code in, what you call this one, in Python. Okay, so let's say there's nothing new here, but anyway, if ever you are stuck with something, then all you have to do is to get to know more about that module, and then try to see the contents of that module. Maybe you will find something new. So that's how it is. So don't forget, if ever you there's a problem, if there's an error, And maybe in that case, there is a package that are missing. Okay, so our next lecture will be focus on computer arithmetic. So we will be defining this one here, the floating point representation of real numbers. So these are the topics next meeting. Okay, we have the IEEE 64-bit operating floating point representation and so much more next meeting. Okay, God bless everyone.